But we really are at an incredible crossroads. And Adam, I was thinking about January 6th when you were talking, and wondering whether or not it triggered it for you. Because Adam and I were both there on January 6th, but what he hasn't said is that we all know that he was one of the main leaders on impeachment. And I, yeah, that's right. Give him a round of applause. And he had to deal with threats from people like the guy that did that massacre all the time, and I imagine you still do, because he had to travel with security. So those threats are still out there. And when I think about what happened at the Tree of Life, I also remember, you know, there were hate crimes that happened around then. You remember right before it was the guy, and it, you know, Trump instigated this because he said that the guy that conducted the massacre, and I'm not sure if this was in the film, but he said that, you know, part of his reason was because of the conspiracy that Jewish folks were bringing people across the border. That was during the time when Trump said we needed to have the army on the border because we were being invaded. And a few weeks before the massacre, there was a guy that was leaving these fake bombs around everybody, and they eventually caught him. Was that covered in the film? And he, when they caught him, his van was filled with all kinds of Trump paraphernalia. A few days before the massacre, there was a white supremacist guy who tried to go into a black church to repeat, you know, what happened in South Carolina. He wasn't able to get in, so he killed two random folks, African-American folks, in a parking lot. And if I'm not mistaken, a few days after Tree of Life, a guy went in and massacred women of color in a yoga studio. And I say that because the, you know, I mean, that was the Trump forces that we're still dealing with. And the thought that some of those people, I think some of the ones from January 6th, didn't some of them win their election? Are they in Congress?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, what? How did we get here with this? So this threat is very, very real. And you said, you know, we won, you know, freedom to vote, freedom to love, but they're trying to take both of that. I mean, especially the freedom to vote, and building in the changes so that they could change the structure of elections. So the threat is real. But just to bring it home, you know, one of the things that I've been amazed by in the 100-plus days I've been at City Hall is the vitriol that happens at City Hall at City Council meetings. And Mike Fuhrer, I'm sure you got your share of it now that you're planning to be a part of my colleagues up here. But, you know, to hear folks come to City Council meetings and call folks the N-word and everything under the sun. And so, you know, we can't consider ourselves immune from this. And I, you know, feel very confident in our city that we are the overwhelming majority and we can defeat this. But it does go on right here. I mean, look at what we had here. I mean, the shooting, the flyers. The flyers really bother me because I feel like that's like the beginning. You know, I mean, it's the flyer, then it's the banner, then it's the shooting. And I'm hoping that we can actually find people through people's Ring cameras at some point where we can stop it and put it out in its tracks.
Thank you. I'm so grateful to all three of you. Thank you so much for taking the time to be here and for just dedicating your lives to working to build a different kind of reality. The realities that we build are often rooted in the stories that we tell, the dreams that we hold. And I want to invite up now Aziza Hassan, who is a dear friend and director of Newground, really one of the leading pioneers in the space throughout the country in bringing Muslims and Jews together. So thank you, Aziza, for being here tonight.